Human carnivore conflict or wildlife animal conflict is the most challenging problem in front of the managers and conservationists. And many times, researchers want to characterize the human wildlife conflict. Then, how to characterize the human wildlife conflict? What are the methodologies? What are the ways? How to analyze the data? This is a big question in front of the researchers. So today we will learn how to characterize the human wildlife conflict with the help of a case study. So this case study is from the Corbett Tiger Reserve, and this is characterization of human tiger conflict in and around the Corbett Tiger Reserve, Uttarakhand. Human carnivore conflict is one of the major issues in front of the managers or the people who involved in the conservation of carnivores. And this problem of human large carnivore conflict have historically occurred where humans are coexisted with wildlife. Attacks on livestock and humans by large carnivores is the major reason behind the human carnivore conflict. And the intensity of this problem also increase with the increase in the population of human and livestock. As with the rise in human and wildlife populations or livestock populations, the area for the wildlife conservation decreased and interference of humans in wildlife areas increased. So this leads to increase in the intensity of problem. Corbett Tiger Reserve is a significant tiger conservation unit under the Project Tiger scheme of Government of India and playing very important role in conservation of tiger in India. In Corbett Tiger Reserve, large carnivores like tiger and leopards attack significant number of cattle of live local communities, and this create antipathy among local communities, and they have negative attitude towards the conservation. And this is the well-known fact that unless we have support of local communities, we are not able to conserve the wild animals. So it is necessary to solve the problem. So there is a utmost need of strategies to mitigate the problem. So there are the two objectives. We can have like an objective for the different studies. So we have two objectives for this study: to determine intensity and factor of human tiger conflict in Corbett Tiger Reserve and to formulate the strategies for mitigation of the problem. So Corbett Tiger Reserve is located in Nainital, Pauri Garhwal and Almora districts of Uttarakhand state of India, and recently that Amangad range of Bijnaut forest division is also included as the buffer zone of the Corbett Tiger Reserve. So we can say that now the Corbett Tiger Reserve is also located, some part of the Corbett Tiger Reserve is also located in Bijnaut district of Uttar Pradesh. So the area of Corbett Tiger Reserve includes Corbett National Park, Sonanadi Wildlife Sanctuary and Bijnaut Forest Division, part of Bijnaut Forest Division. And that Corbett Tiger Reserve is spread over an area of 1288.31 square kilometer, and it also an 80.6 square kilometer of Amangad range. Vegetation of the area is quite heterogeneous and various forest types are found in the Corbett Tiger Reserve. As per the Champion and Sate classification, eight forest types are found in Corbett Tiger Reserve. Sal is the most prominent tree species of Corbett Tiger Reserve. So what are the methods we can use to collect the data to characterize the human tiger conflict or human wildlife conflict? So under this study, first we collected the secondary data from the forest department to get the initial knowledge of the problem, and on the basis of this we divided the area into intensive and extensive study area. And then the, in intensive study area, we have the focus on the intensive study area. So research team, whenever an attack on livestock or human reported by the forest department or the villagers, the research team visited the place and collect the data on various factor which leads to attack on humans or the cattle. And data are collected on predator species, species killed, health, age and sex of species. To determine how much the loss is incurred by the local communities, current market prices of species were taken from the market. And livestock species are divided into adult, subadult, calf and weaner, and on the basis of their age categories, the price was set. Livestock died due to injury during the treatment were also included while calculating the total loss incurred to local communities. Chi-square goodness of fit test was used to test significance difference among different categories. 47 humans were attacked by wild animal during the study period. Tiger contributed most part of this attack, as tiger contributed 40.2% of total attacks on humans in the study periods, and a total of 19 humans were attacked by the tiger, and out of these 19, 14 were males and rest were females. And this table provide the number of humans attacked by different wild animals in Corbett Tiger Reserve. So this table, this graph provide the number of humans attacked by wildlife during different year or during the study period. During 2002, no human attack by wild animal was recorded. So we can say that attacks are not regular, and maximum number of attacks were reported during 2005, while the minimum number of attacks were reported during 2006. So what are the repercussions of tiger attack, or whenever like a tiger attack, what are the outcomes? So situation become very strenuous for forest department when a carnivore attack humans, as local people react aggressively after attack of tigers on human, and especially when attacks on human leads to death, and they put pressure on forest department to eliminate the tigers. Three tigers were eliminated from in and around the Corbett Tiger Reserve in response of tiger human conflict, and no case of persecution or poisoning by local communities in response to attack by carnivores was recorded during the study period. If we are taking the conflict in terms of livestock depredation, 3027 incident of carnivore on livestock were recorded during the study period. Out of this, tiger attacked 1924 livestock, while leopard attacked 1103 livestock. And these livestock are from, so we can, if we take the that average, then it is recorded that 12 animals per village is attacked by tiger during the study period. Maximum livestock attacks were recorded from Belghatti Gujarkhata, located in southern portion of the Corbett Tiger Reserve. Distribution of livestock attacked by tiger differed significantly among the different livestock classes, and tiger attacked more cows in comparison of buffaloes, and horse, mule, they are attacked in very very, cow is like largely killed by the tiger, and while the horse and mule, these are the species which are very very few individuals of these species attacked by tiger. So this graph shows the season wise distribution of livestock attacked by tiger, and maximum number of tiger attack were recorded during the monsoon, while the minimum number of attack recorded during the post monsoon, and there is a significant difference between the season. So this table provide the economic loss incurred to local livestock owners from 2002 to 2016, and we can say that like a drastic, very very huge amount of economic loss incurred to local community just because of livestock attacked by tiger. So in conclusion, we can say that tiger does not consider human beings as their prey species, and only 3 incidents of human got killed by tiger were reported. So we can say the attack on humans are purely accidental, and economic loss due to attack on livestock is the most important issue in the study area, and it is the only contributing reason behind the human carnivore conflict in the areas. Economic loss due to livestock damage is 42,831 rupees per village. It may be an acceptable figure at community level, but when tiger attacked many or more than one livestock of a single family, then it is not acceptable a figure on a human or a individual basis level, because it totally ruined the economy of a local farm. So what can we do to stop this, or we can do to reduce the problem of human tiger conflict or human carnivore conflict in the Corbett Tiger Reserve? So practical skills to local communities to avoid potential attacks should be provided. That forest department and local NGOs who work in these areas, they should organize workshop for local communities to equip them with the practical skills to local community to avoid potential attack. And better livestock management practices should be encouraged in the area so that we can reduce the attack on livestock. Owner friendly faster compensation schemes should be encouraged, because at present these compensation schemes are very cumbersome and they are not owner friendly, and there should be a timely revision of rate of compensation so that local communities get the compensation on time and appropriate compensation for their loss. So we are thankful to Uttarakhand Forest Department, the Corbett Foundation, Aligarh Muslim University and people of Corbett Tiger Reserve. Thank you.